Hey everyone, I upgraded to Windows 11 2 years ago, and overall I really like it, even if the Windows Start menu thing seems to open edge at every opportunity. That's annoying, but my main annoyance with Windows 11 is the right-click menu. The first thing I do, or used to do, on any Windows install is to download Notepad++ and 7-zip, so it was pretty annoying at first when I right-clicked some files, and Windows just went, meh, computer said no, and showed me a bunch of useless options. Now, the way that this new context menu, in other words, the right-click menu, works in Windows 11 isn't actually a bug, it's by design. It's intentional. But if you dislike it or you can't get used to it, here's 6 ways to bring back Windows 10-style right-click menus. Firstly, when you do open the context menu by right-clicking a folder or a file, you'll see a Show More Options item appears at the very bottom. When you click this, it'll then open the legacy Windows 10 context menu, and then you can open 7-zip, Notepad++, or whatever else you're looking for. Simple. Thanks for watching this video. Kidding. This obviously is a bit of a clunky way of using the right-click menu. Having to constantly click twice gets annoying very quickly. The second way to fix this is even easier and quicker, to be honest. Just hold down the Shift key on your keyboard and then right-click at the same time. It will then immediately bring up the old-style menu. Nice. It even looks like the old menu, Microsoft haven't even bothered to style it and blend it into Windows 11. It's almost like Bill Gates is sulking, you don't love and cherish the new style context menu. In fact, Bill Gates is probably on a yacht somewhere, but you get my point. To be honest, this is the method that I tend to use on Windows 11, but holding down 2 keys, you know, the Shift key and the mouse key, won't work for everyone. Which brings me on to my third suggestion. Try upgrading the program. Not every program on here will tell you when they have an update. They're not like our phones that force updates on us every 5 bloody minutes. When I first moved to Windows 11 2 years ago, Notepad++ hadn't actually been fully updated with Windows 11 support, and so it wasn't showing in the new style right-click menus, but now it does. I don't know exactly when the Notepad++ devs updated this, but the Windows developer blog goes into lots of detail about how and why Windows 11 changed the context menu, and how programs can now appear in this new style menu. This means that if the program you're running is from a few years ago, it probably won't appear in the new menu because it just hasn't been updated to be Windows 11 friendly. So if there is a newer version of a program which doesn't appear in the Windows 11 menu, then try upgrading to it, restarting your PC, and check to see if it now appears. Hopefully it does. But if it doesn't, my fourth suggestion is to just look at alternate programs. For example, 7-zip doesn't seem to have been updated to support Windows 11 menus yet. But thankfully, somebody forked the code. I said forked, all right. And created NanaZip. This has been updated to support Windows 11 and is best to install it via the Microsoft Store, according to the developer. Once that's complete, restart your PC and then try this out. You should now see NanaZip appearing in the new right-click menu. Yes! I'm not sure why I find that so exciting. I guess I just missed 7-zip. And NanoZip works pretty much the same way because it started out as the same underlying code. It was forked. So that's all good. But what happens if your application doesn't have any pending updates or alternatives? Well, solution 5 is that you could just give up on the new Windows menu altogether and install a program like Explorer Patcher or WinAero Tweaker. These allow you to change large parts of the Windows 11 UI. The user interface, including bringing back the girl-fashioned Windows 10 context menu. To do this, let's say that you downloaded WinAero Tweaker, which you could do from the website. Click the download button to download the zip file installer, and then extract it out using whichever file extractor you prefer, although Windows' own one should work fine. Then click the .exe file and follow the steps to install WinAero Tweaker. This is all fairly standard. Once it's finished, launch the program, read and agree to the disclaimer if you're happy to do that, and then look for the classic full context menus option under the Windows 11 sidebar. Go in here and toggle the box and then click Restart Explorer. This is pretty neat actually. Instead of having to restart your whole PC, WinAero Tweaker will just restart the single Explorer process, meaning that you can then immediately see this change straight away on the right-click menu. So now you can launch File Explorer and behold, the new context menu no longer exists. Explorer Patcher also works well, but this project is more designed for rolling back the Windows 11 interface and restoring most of the Windows 10 look and feel. So if you're just looking to get the old right-click menu behaviour back, then Explorer Patcher might not be right for you. But if Windows 11 was forced on you and you dislike it, then Explorer Patcher could be ideal for you. The final option I have for you is to use a single registry edit to bring back the old context menu. Now, this is the most technical approach in this video because the Windows Registry Editor can be unsafe if you mess around with it. In the worst case, you could break your Windows install. So you should only attempt registry edits if you know what you're doing. Having said all that, this particular edit should be fairly safe. There's two ways you can do this, but the easiest way is to just run a single command in the Windows command line terminal. And I've put this command down in the description if you wanted to check that out. To get started, search for terminal on here and make sure that you open it as administrator by clicking the more arrow in the right. Then copy and paste the command into this window by right-clicking in the terminal. Press enter on your keyboard and hey presto, all your base will belong to us. Kidding. Restart your PC and when it starts back up, rejoice! The Windows 11 context menu is gone for good and the purdy Windows 10 one is back. Nice. And that wraps up today's video. As you can tell, there's quite a few potential solutions here, ranging from the simple, like hold it down and shift on your keyboard, to the more technical. Which is your favorite? Well, please let me know down in the comments. I hope you liked this video and found it useful. If you did, please click the thumbs up button. This tells the YouTube algorithm that more people should see this video. Please also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thanks for watching.